Hi everyone, it's Nicole Wilkins with FitnessRx for Women, and this is my next fit tip. Today I'm going to be talking about six common fitness myths and why they're not true. The first one I wrote down is women who lift weights will get bulky muscles. Now, most of us who are watching this video work out with weights on a regular basis and know how difficult it is to gain muscle. I lift really, really heavy and I have been lifting weights for almost 15 years and I'm not a huge, huge woman. So it does take a lot of work, and women don't have as much testosterone as men, so it makes it that much harder for us to gain that lean muscle tissue. So the bulkiness that some people may complain about is body fat. So if they lose the body fat, then you'll be able to see more definition and muscle definition from the weight training. So women who lift weights won't get bulky. Spot reducing is possible. Not. Meaning if you just do 1,000 crunches every single day, you're not gonna get six-pack abs. You've gotta do more than just that. If you lose body fat, it actually comes from all over your body. It doesn't just come from one particular place. So it's a culmination of a lot of things. Unfortunately, it would be great if you had your arms just the way you wanted them, but you had a little bit of body fat on your legs and you just did squats and then your arms stayed the same and then your legs got leaner. But unfortunately, it doesn't really work that way. Body fat comes off all at once and all throughout your body, and it comes on all throughout your body at the same time. No pain, no gain. Now, there are two different ways of looking at pain. When you're weight training and you're feeling the burning, like you feel the muscle swelling, you feel blood flow increasing to the area that you're working, it burns and it kind of makes you want to stop, that's okay. But when you feel a pain, like an ouch pain where you have to stop and it doesn't go away as soon as that exercise is complete, that is a pain you want to avoid. So yes, you want to push yourself, you want to feel that burning, but if you have a pain, don't go anymore. Exercise requires a hefty time commitment, which isn't true. It doesn't require a hefty time commitment, unless of course you're training for a marathon and then you have to rack miles during your long runs, which can take a few hours. But on a regular basis, it does require a time commitment, just not hours in the gym every single day. For those who do CrossFit, you can get a great WOD in 10-15 minutes. If you do high intensity interval training, you can get a great workout in 20-30 minutes. If you weight train on a consistent basis, you know that you can get a good weight training workout in 45 minutes to an hour. So I recommend, an hour 5 to 6 times a week if you want to make some significant changes in your body. It doesn't require a hefty time commitment, but yeah, it requires a time commitment. So hefty, no. If you exercise, you can eat whatever you want. Now, obviously we know, all of us know someone who can just eat whatever they want and still have this great body. But for the most of us, we have to watch what we eat and can't just rely on exercise alone. I know a lot of people I see in the gym on a regular basis, year after year, who are really great with keeping up with their exercise program, but their bodies never change. And then they're wondering why they're not seeing results. If you work out for an hour and then you go home and have a burger and fries and potato chips every night, you basically ate what you burnt off and then some. So you're not really, are you getting the benefits of the strength training? Of course, but you're not really going to see a whole lot of drops in body fat or changes in the physical physique. You've really got to change the way you eat. And the last tip I have, or myth I want to debunk, is there is a magic fix, like quick fix out there. We see this all the time in the newspaper, on TV, in the magazines, just everywhere. New fad diets, new pills, new shots, new whatever. And the bottom line is, will they all work? Yes, to a point. But what are you going to do as soon as that diet is over? You want to be prepared and think about what you're going to do for life. So I don't know about you, but I couldn't eat cabbage soup for life. So whatever you embark on, think about, am I going to be able to do this longer than 6 weeks or 8 weeks? And if not, then rethink what you can do to make it work. There are so many methods out there and so many ways to get in shape and so many different programs. You have to find what works best for you. So there is no quick fix. You got to have weight training, cardiovascular exercise for the heart, as well as a sound, whole, nutritious program with, you know, treats in moderation. And that is when you're going to see the most changes in your body. So those are six myths that are not true. That's my fit tip for this week. Until next week, keep working out hard and keep training hard. I will see you next time.